with the representation of the Birkenhead Institute Old Boys. Thank you.
Thanks, Paul. We heard from the residents about their concerns regarding traffic issues, and particularly U-turns, and I'd personally like to hear from the highway engineer about that.
Thank you for your chair. I mean, it's true to say that that junction there at Hayes Drive hasn't been identified as a priority for any traffic management action in the past. But in my investigation of this proposal and observations on site, I feel that there would be a need to implement a prohibition of U-turn border at the junction of Hayes Drive. And that is suggested condition 12 on page 38. In terms of the access in and out of the site, currently it's only wide enough for one vehicle. So I'm suggesting in condition 11 on page 37 that the access is widened to cater for two-way traffic so that we don't have a situation where vehicles are queuing on the LEASOWE ROAD whilst waiting for another vehicle to come out of the site. Subject to those two conditions, I don't feel there are any grounds to object to this application on highway safety.
Do anybody else on the planning committee want to make any comments? Ask any questions? I have a recommendation for all of that.
Yeah, through you, Chair, that's why we have looked at the issue of retaining the pavilion, but there are reasons why that can't be maintained. The plaque in it, as it suggested in the report, will be moved permanently to Hamilton Square.
If I could just comment through the Chair to say that the Council's received a letter today from the Birkenhead Institute Old Boys, which has come into the Chief Executive, which has been passed to me for response. I can assure members of the committee and the Birkenhead Institute that the Council will work with them constructively around the removal of the plaque to a suitable location in Hamilton Square in respect of those men who gave their lives for this country in the war. We'll also work constructively around the tree issues on site as well to try and preserve that in memory of those people who have fallen. There are conditions attached to the INGLEBOROUGH ROAD report which actually cover that. The issue why nothing has happened over the past couple of years since this application last came to the committee is because the although this committee approved both of the link proposals, for a variety of reasons they weren't able to progress Apple Church, and therefore alternative sites had to be looked at, and it's been part of that process. So the commitments given at that time will be honoured by the Council if these applications are approved. And there are conditions that Council officers will ensure are rigorously enforced to make that happen. And in the discussions we've had with Tranmere Rovers as part of this application, they've given commitments as well to work with the Council on those particular matters, obviously with respect to those men who have fell in the first book.
I understand that the Ben Institute of Boys have tried to contact the representations and I have received those signal. Is there any assurance that this doesn't happen
again? I can't speak for Tranmere Rovers. I can only speak for the Council, and only to say that, you know, through the work that David Armstrong and I have done in and around this application, the conditions that we have proposed in support of this application tonight, and the letter that I will send back through the Chief Executive to the Birkenhead Institute over the next few days, it will reaffirm the Council's firm commitment to dealing with these issues sensitively, to make sure they are dealt with appropriately and that all steps are done. So the Council will ensure that those things will happen. And as I say again, from the discussions we've had with Tranmere Rovers, they seem to be of the same mind as well with regards to these things. I can't comment on the Birkenhead Institute or Boys and their direct contracts with Tranmere Rovers, because that's not part of my responsibility. But I can give members those assurances that all those matters will be dealt with sensitively and in line with the condition of the report.
Finally, then, I wonder if Birkenhead or Boys Institute can just communicate with me.
If they wish to do that, then that's absolutely fine by me, and we'll facilitate everything and make sure it's all done appropriately and hopefully to everybody's satisfaction. And I'm quite happy to lead personally on those discussions along with my colleague David Armstrong as well. So this matter's dealt with at a very senior level within the Council, and I'm happy to give those assurances to members on those two matters.
Yeah, thank you, Chair. Just a minor point really, relating to conditions. The site that we're looking at Inglebury Road is consistently surrounded by quite attractive two-storey houses. I'd like to see some sort of condition imposed on what is an open, an outline application, that the ridge heights of the properties to be erected will not exceed more than those that surround them. I gather that the difficulty in imposing two-storey limitation because people might want to put rooms and dormer in the roof space. But I'd like the officers, if possible, to recommend how we could include a condition that would not allow these houses to be far too tall and therefore out of character with the individual surroundings.
Thank you, through you, Chair. This application is an outline application, so the details, the scale, external appearance, all of those sorts of things would be considered in a reserved matters application. If a reserved matters application came forward, for example, with three-storey dwellings on it, and as part of the consideration of that reserved matters, we felt three stories didn't fit in with the character of the area, then we would be able to deal with that as part of the reserved matters application. So I think there is still a significant level of control for members and the council in ensuring that two-storey goes on the Inglebrough site eventually as part of the reserved matters application. The Section 106 agreement deals with the provision of replacement facilities that will be lost at Inglebroughs Road. The requirement for replacement facilities in the National Planning Policy Framework and Sport England's requirement doesn't require the replacement to be made in the same ward or within the same locality. The replacement just needs to be provided within the borough. The Section 106 agreement that's proposed for these linked applications also ensures that any money from the sale of the land at Ingleborough is placed into an account to be used solely for the provision of the the new
could I just ask you to keep your comments to yourself until Matthew's finished, because he was burnt in automatic.
Thank you, through you, Chair. Just to continue, so the Section 106 agreement requires the payment to be made into an escrow account to ensure that the replacement facilities at LEASOWE are provided within a timescale set out in the Section 106 agreement before the development of Ingleborough Road and proceeds. So we are satisfied that there is a sufficient secure sufficient detail in the 106 agreement to secure all of those details.
I think that there have been some comments about the difference between the One Church application and the LEASOWE application in relation to Section 106. But can I just remind members that they are separate applications and we have to consider the applications on the table tonight. Matthew just wants to pick up on the accessibility issue.
Thank you, through you, Chair. In terms of accessibility of the site at LEASOWE, LEASOWE Road is a main route. There are links to public transport for this application that link this site to the rest of the borough, particularly the proximity of the site to Wallasey Village and the railway station there. So the proposals at LEASOWE are very accessible, not just for the LEASOWE community, but for the borough as a whole.
Stuart? Mr. Hughes in his presentation was kind enough to recall the comments that were made 2 years ago when the application was last in front of the committee. And at that stage, I think I tended to outline to the committee my thought process on this, because the starting point is that it's a departure from the development plan. It ought to be refused, therefore, on those grounds, unless circumstances outweigh the loss. And when we talk about the loss, there's two issues that weigh heavily on my mind that I wanted to be said about. One was obviously the loss of recreation plan, but the second issue was, as described as heritage, isn't it? But it was the whole issue of what was in the mind of the people of Beckerlis, who was at the time, when they laid out the field, when they laid out the pavilion, what did they want to achieve? And my conclusion was, they wanted to achieve a sporting facility, initially, of course, for their own use, and in fact, exclusively for their own use, but certainly for young people playing sports in Birmingham. That's what was on their mind. And Mr. Hughes, in his remarks, was kind enough to say that mine were well thought out, and no doubt 2 years ago, he left the room disappointed that at that time I moved approval of the application on the grounds that I saw the replacement facilities at Woodchurch, in other words, still in Birkenhead, as a suitable replacement and as something that would have fitted, if you like, what was in the mind of the people that laid out the BI at the Ingleborough Road field at that time. It was, in my view, a suitable replacement. I won't be approval of this one. I don't think I'll be voting for this one, because I don't think that we've now got in front of us a suitable replacement. And Matthew's read from paragraph 74 of the Planning Policy Framework and Sports England's guidance. And the issue is this. Would the replacement be a best provision in terms of policy, etc., and in a suitable location? Okay, now, we can define that any which way we want, but ultimately, suitable is a subjective word. It is for us to determine what is suitable. It is not really for Sport England to determine, sitting in an office somewhere in the northwest or London, to say, well, it looks like a suitable application, it's still within the board. But is it suitable in all the circumstances? The circumstances being that we're talking about something that was put in place for Berwick, and my view, the suitable location should remain in Berwick. That's why I was keen to move approval of the previous application. Now, I'm not seeing a suitable size. I'm not seeing something that is replacing the facility that's to be lost in a suitable location. Now, I know, Chair, I've been advised, as you've been advised by officers, that I mustn't harp on about woodsheds, and I don't want to. Except to say that when the woodshed one was in front of us, we didn't have any objection, any petitions or objection. In fact, we had a sports facility in our ownership, which we felt we could share with Tony Williams. In this case, moving to agenda item 5, we have recreation land, open land, which has been proposed to be fenced off in places. There's a lot of amenity there, I would suggest. We have at least one petition of residents of Hayes Drive raising issues, again, of amenity and of traffic safety. So it doesn't, unlike the previous application, enjoy the same sorts of support from the local community. In my view, there's a good application for this house, already approved today. So it can be implemented with sufficient goodwill on all parts. I'm not happy with this, the replacement location, and won't be supporting.
It seems to me, just briefly, that one of the issues we've got here across the three, across both of these things that have been submitted tonight, is an issue around communication. There's a lot of passion and a lot of emotion rising here. We're talking about future for young people, we're talking about remembering our youth that died 100 years ago. And I can appreciate that the passions are going very, very high. And I really am torn, I literally am going from one argument to the other and really trying to thread my way through the arguments as best as I can. One of the things that I would say is that if this does move forward, what I really, really urge Tranmere Rovers to do is to actually have real and meaningful dialogue, both with the Birkenhead Institute Old Boys and with the residents of Hayes community and any other members of the LEASOWE community. I'm particularly minded to mention the fact that I don't think that the facilities that Tranmere, the current Sports England application talk about in terms of the community are adequate at all. Just talking about pitches and no kinds of training, no kind of changing room facilities, which I don't, I think there has to be far more dialogue between Tranmere and the LEASOWE community about a real community provision there. And I am wanted to hear some of the points that Councillor Kelly's just made as well regarding church and the role away from our position there. Another final quick comment is that I know where I live, I live right near Wilford and close, and I also think that maybe there's a conversation, some dialogue to be had around the councillors, if the officers are listening. Haven't got the officers' attention. I also think that there should be some dialogue with the BI Old Boys around maybe if this does go ahead, renaming the estate in some way that commemorates
Thanks, Chris. What I think might be beneficial is if I ask Matthew if you can see a visual of where the building will be.
Thank you, through you, Chair. So this was the, I'll just go back to that plan. So it's this part of the site. So this is where the temporary buildings, the changing facilities would be. They're all single storey. This is the proposed car park.
And the question was asked about the fencing. I believe this is a 5 metre fencing. Can you just clarify what type of fencing that's likely to be?
Yeah, I just need to get up a different plan to start. Thank you, through you, Chair. So this is where the Tranmere Rovers facilities will be. This fence here, and down here, and along here, is a 2.1 metre palisade fence. If it was 10 centimetres shorter, it wouldn't require permission, it would be permitted development. The 5 metre high fence runs along the boundary with LEASOWE Road, and that's required to prevent balls going onto LEASOWE Road. And that's not a palisade fence, that's like a net fence.
Okay, are there any other questions for the committee?
Yes, through you, Chair. At the site visit the other day, my understanding was that the green type fence that would be along that road that was to stop walls going out would be within the tree line, is that correct? That would not be noticeable from the pictures.
That's right, yes.
From the report that piece of land that's now shown dotted is open land open to the public, etc. But you've just said that somebody could pull a fence up without planning permission. Presumably if they owned it, do you mean? Okay, so that got, unless we agree to lose, effectively, that amount of open green space. So not only are we losing the facility of INGLEBOROUGH ROAD, which arguably you never had to start with because of its importance to the school and entertainment. But we're also now losing this piece of land. So where's the replacement, where's the extra for that? So we're tending to meet two different things, aren't we? It's amenity and open space.
But the requirement is for the replacement provision of playing fields or sports grounds. There's no pitches on that part of the site.
I wasn't suggesting what, but I was suggesting it was open amenity land, which would still have to demonstrate some special circumstances for us to sort of afford development.
Yeah.
Okay, the officers
Mine's just a quick question relating back to the INGLEBOROUGH site. And it was mentioned by one of the petitioners, but also in the report it suggests that it would not be considered viable for the requirement of social housing and all that. Now the suggestion is that obviously since the last application, prices have for many reasons increased land value and house prices. And at the same time, the Tranmere Rovers are spending less than they were on the Woodchurch site. Has this been looked into again?
Through you, Chair. Since the proposals at INGLEBOROUGH ROAD were last considered in 2012, the viability assessment has been revised, updated, and it has been independently assessed on behalf of the council again. The assessment, the result that has come back from that independent appraisal is that affordable housing isn't viable at this moment in time, but there is a mechanism in the Section 106 agreement that if land values increase, then they would need to make a contribution to affordable housing.
Sorry, I'll show you. Just a brief clarification. I share my but I understand one, that this isn't a green belt, and two, that this type of record sport operation belt is
right, just to expand on that point, recreation and sport are considered to be acceptable, appropriate uses in green belt here.
Okay, are there any other questions or comments from the committee? The officer's recommendation is to approve subject to the conditions listed and section 106 agreement. I've been advised by the